All the details, and I have base 2 details to 7.
What makes the news depends on the station, the newspaper, the producer, and who's the audience. Quite often producers are making decisions on what they're running first based on what they think their audience is interested in.
Do you have a specific code of ethics when you shoot, or does anything go?
When I'm out shooting, I shoot exactly what is happening. I don't edit, I don't not shoot things, I shoot it as it happens. So I'm not changing anything. I don't think it's a question of ethics. It's just a matter of I'm out there, I'm showing the public what happened. There's no distortion in what I shoot. What you saw in those pictures is exactly what happened. And if you hadn't seen those pictures, you would have never known what Aslan Williams saw that day, what those SWAT team members were wearing that day. I was driving in my car when I heard a call which suggested there possibly might be a raid that afternoon. I went to the police station, at the time they had said, and when I got there, out was pulling the SWAT team truck. In back of the SWAT team truck, there were Broncos, there were marked cruisers and unmarked cruisers. I just jumped in back of them and followed them. We drove about 2 miles, and then we arrived at 118 Whitfield Street, the home of Reverend Aslan Williams, and they all jumped out with their gear, and I jumped out with my cameras and ran up the street and just ducked behind a car and started taking pictures.
The police set up barricades. There was a scuffle. This turned into a riot, and it spread through Central Harlem. Negroes threw bottles at the police. Orders to disperse were ignored, and huge crowds swarmed through the streets.
Right now, he's planning a slum fire that'll kill thousands.
It's like a hall of cross to the boss when I talk. Too much knowledge kicked in, you're lost in a shuffle of beat. Jinx the fiddler, and I control your mind like Hitler. You're bowing down to a sword. I see now, sucker with a